Today we see how to conduct the impact test. This test is conducted to determine the impact strength of the material. This test can be conducted in two different methods. One is IZARD test, another one is CHARPY test. The specimens used for conducting the IZARD and CHARPY test. IZARD test is having a V notch at a distance of 1/3 of its length from the top end, whereas CHARPY test specimen is having a V notch at the center. This is the machine used to conduct the impact test. This machine is of pendulum type, contains striking hammer at the left hand side and the dial reading scale on top of the machine. This scale contains two types of scales. One is the inner scale, which is used to measure the IZARD strength or IZARD value, whereas the outer scale is used to measure the CHARPY value. This is the lever used for setting the machine. The lever is set to the bottom position to conduct the IZARD test, whereas it has been set to the top position to conduct the CHARPY test. At the bottom of the machine, there is a provision to fix the workpiece with the help of the attachments or anvils. This lever is used to lock or unlock the shackles. This lever is used to release the pendulum. This is the striking attachment, which is fixed onto the striking hammer.
Just as the two faces, one is the sharp edges, another one is the flat edges. So the sharp edges are used to carry out the CHARPY test and flat edges are used to carry out the
To conduct the CHARPY test, the specimen is fixed on the shackles in such a way that the V notch should be opposite to the striking hammer. To conduct the IZARD test, the specimen is fixed in the cantilever position in such a way that the V notch should be towards the striking edge. To conduct the experiment, the initial dimensions of the specimens are noted down. To conduct the CHARPY test, the pendulum should be lifted up to a 30 kg force. Make sure that the initial reading should be set to zero. Now release the So this is the CHARPY impact value of the material. Calculate the final values or the strength of the specimen, impact strength of the specimen by referring the